أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق، أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق، أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت، خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت، أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي، فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا. اللهم إني أصبحت أشهدك وأشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. اللهم إني أصبحت أشهدك وأشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. اللهم إني أصبحت أشهدك وأشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. اللهم إني أصبحت أشهدك وأشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. اللهم ما أصبح بي من نعمة فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك، لك الحمد ولك الشكر. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. فسبحان الله حين تمسون وحين تصبحون، وله الحمد في السماوات والأرض وشيا وحين تظهرون. يخرج الحي من الميت ويخرج الميت من الحي، ويحيي الأرض بعد موتها وكذلك تخرجون. إن شاء الله next week we'll continue with the rest إن شاء الله تعالى. May Allah give us consistency in our actions. Allahu Ameen, inshallah. Okay, if you can open up your Nahu workbook. Okay, so Bismillah, let's start, inshallah. Okay, so the first thing We, over the last two lessons, you learnt about the pronoun. So let's say the whole list together, the huwa, whom. Let's say the whole list together, inshallah. Huwa, whom, hiya, hunna, anta, antum, anti, antunna, ana, nahnu. Again. Huwa, whom, hiya, hunna, anta, antum, anti, antunna, ana, nahnu. One more time. Huwa, whom, hiya, hunna, anta, antum, anti, antunna, ana, nahnu. Say to your part of a memory, inshallah. Memory means not looking, eh? Did your partner say it back to you as well? Okay, so all of these pronouns here are all what we call detached pronouns. Detached because they appear on their own in the word. Like if I say is tall, and I say huwa tawilun, what's the meaning of that? He is tall. Anta tawilun. Anta tawilun. You are male, you are tall. Ana tawilun. I am tall. And a female, I'll say, hiya, not tawilun, hiya tawilatun. It was a female, tamarbuta. Hiya tawilatun. She is tall. Anti tawilatun. Not the anti is tall. You one female is tall. Okay, you with me. But we're not going to focus on that now. I want to focus on your homework. Because that's why you got homework. Now, so your homework was. Okay, so we are on page, just to make sure you're on the right page, we're on page 28 of your workbook. Page 28 of your workbook. On page 28 of your workbook, you will see two lists there on the right-hand side. The first one is going to be detached pronouns. So the detached pronouns we just did now, huwa, whom, hiya, hunna, anta, antum, anti, antunna, ana, nahnu. Then the next one in the grey there is called attached pronouns. The, why are they called attached? Because they're always attached to a word. They always appear at the end of a word. They're attached because they always appear at the end of a word. So if a who, that first one, if a who appears at the end of the word, it means him. If a whom appears at the end of the word, it means them, not if female, should be M, male or mixed group. You can change it there, should be M. If a whom appears at the end of the word, it should be them, males or mixed group. If a ha appears at the end of a word, it is her. If it's hunna, it is them. If it's ka, you one male, kum, you many males or mixed group, ki, you one female, kunna, you many females, e, I, me, or na, we. So your homework was to do the exercise. So if you go to number one, it says sami'a hu. Sami'a hu. So the approach when you see this is to break up the word in your mind. There's two words there, there's sami'a. And there's who. What does sami'a mean? He heard. And sami'ahu He heard him. Next one, sami'aka. Again, we're breaking up the word to what? To sami'a plus ka. What does sami'a mean? He heard. And ka? You, one male. So sami'aka, he heard you. He heard you, one male. He heard you. Next one, sami'akum. He heard. He heard you. He heard you all. Naam. He heard all of you. He heard you, the plural you. He heard you. Next one. Sami'tuha. Now, what are the two words there? Sami'tu plus ha. So, what's the sami'tu part, you know, from your scales? Sami'a, 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 sami'u, all the way down. What's sami'tu? I heard. So, sami'tu is I heard. What does ha mean? So sami'tu her. I heard her. I heard her. Next one. Sami'tuki. Let's put up again. What does sami'tu mean? I heard. And ki? You, one female. So sami'tuki. I heard you. One female in brackets. I heard you. Next one. Sami'tuna. Again, bracket up. Sami'tu. I heard na us. Sami'tuna. I heard us. So we'll be all reciting and then someone hears themselves reciting. Sami'tuna. I heard us. Next one. Sami'tuhum. Sami'tu. I heard. Sami'tuhum. I heard them. Again, this attached pronoun at the attached pronoun at the end of the word is the most common thing in the Quran. It's very, very common. All the time you're gonna find it. Next one, darabtahu. Let's break it up. What does darabta mean? You, one male, you hit. Darabtahu. You hit him. You hit him. You hit him. Next one, darabtana. Darabta. You hit. Darabtana, you hit us. You should be marking your homework here, not writing the answers. So if you're writing the answers, please feel very guilty. I want you laden with guilt, inshallah. And make a firm niyyah, inshallah, next time. Next week is going to be different. Ramadan is starting. I'm going to change my life, change my habits. I'm going to do my homework, inshallah. No. Next one. Darabtani. Darabta? What's darabta? You hit. Darabtani? The E is me. Darabta? You hit. Darabtani? You hit me. You hit me. Next one. Darabtahum. Darabta? You hit. Darabtahum? You hit them. Next one. Nasarnaha. So let's back it up. The word is Nasarna first. If you go down, Nasara, Nasaru, Nasarat, Nasarna, Nasarta, Nasartum, Nasarti, Nasar Tunna, Nasartu, Nasarna. We helped. Nasarna, we helped. Nasarnaha, we helped her. We helped her. Next one. Nasartuhum. Nasartu. Nasartu. I helped. Nasartuhum. I helped them. Next one. Khalaqnakum. Very common in the Quran. Khalaqa. Khalaqa means create. Khalaqna. We created. Khalaqnakum. We created you. We created all of you. Khalaqnakum. We created all of you. خلقناه خلقنا we created خلقناه we created him. Sometimes Allah refers to himself as na, the royal we, and sometimes Allah refers to himself as I. The next one says خلقتكم خلقت I created خلقت I created خلقتكم I created you. I created all of you. I created you. خلقتكم. Okay. Until there, all the verbs were past tense. Until there, all the verbs were past tense. فعل ماضي, فعل, فعلوا, فعلت, فعلنا, and so on. Now the same thing applies to present tense مضاري verbs, like يفعلوا. For example, we have the word here, يسمعه. What's يسمع mean? He is hearing, he is listening, he is hearing. يسمعه. He is hearing him. يسمعه. He is hearing him. He is hearing him. Present tense, not he heard him. He is hearing him because it is present tense. Next one. نَسْمَعُكُمْ. So if it gets difficult, you just break it up. You say, what does نَسْمَعُ mean? What does نَسْمَعُ mean? We are hearing. We are hearing. نَسْمَعُكُمْ. We are hearing you, all of you. نَسْمَعُكُمْ. We are hearing all of you. Next one. نَسْمَعُكِ. نَسْمَعُ. Just read from your page there. نَسْمَعُ. We are hearing. كِ. We are hearing you, one female. Next one. يَسْمَعُونَكَ. So just break it up. يَسْمَعُونَ. Let's go from the top. يَسْمَعُ. يَسْمَعُونَ. Like يَفْعَلُ. يَفْعَلُونَ. يَسْمَعُ. يَسْمَعُونَ. What does يَسْمَعُونَ mean? They, many, males or mixed group are hearing. Not females, males or mixed group. يَسْمَعُ. يَفْعَلُونَ. يَسْمَعُ. يَسْمَعُونَ. They are hearing ka. They are hearing you, one male. They are hearing you, one male. Next one. أَسْمَعُهُ. Let's break it up. What's أَسْمَعُ? I am hearing. If you go down, يَسْمَعُ, يَسْمَعُونَ, تَسْمَعُ, يَسْمَعْنَ, all the way down, أَسْمَعُ. I am hearing who? I am hearing him. Next one. تَضْرِبُنِي. تَضْرِبُنِي. What does تَضْرِبُ mean? Let's go through our scale. يَضْرِبُ quickly. يَضْرِبُ. يَضْرِبُونَ. تَضْرِبُ. يَضْرِبْنَ. تَضْرِبُ. There's two تَضْرِبُس. Could mean she is hitting or could mean you is hitting. You are hitting. There's no context here, so we can't decipher. So let's go with she or you. Either she is hitting or you are hitting. تَضْرِبُنِي. You are hitting me. You one female hitting me. Or she is eating me. Not you one female, sorry, you one male, or she is eating me. Adribuka. Adribu. I am eating you. Nansuruhu. Nansuru. There's a mistake, they're not Nansurah, eh? Nansuru. There must be a uh on the Dhamma. Nansuru. Must be a uh on the Dhamma. Nansuruhu. We are helping him. I'm only hearing the aunties on the chair. Brothers, what's happening? Nansuruhu. We are helping him. Okay, now aunties, now give the brothers a chance, inshallah. Tansuruhum. What's the answer? Brothers, you must jawab. Jawab comes from the word jawab, which means to answer. She is helping them. She is helping them. Or it could be you, one male. Because there's two tansurus. Yansuru, yansuruna, tansuru, yansurna, tansuru, tansuruna. There's two tansurus. Last one. Last one's in the Quran all the time. Yas'alunaka. Sa'ala yas'alu means to ask. What does yas'aluna mean? Yas'alu, yas'aluna. They are asking. Who are they asking? They are asking you. You one male. Yes, alunaka, they are asking you. Okay. So the first step was just for you to get used to it. So hopefully you're a little bit used to it now, inshallah. If you did your homework, you'd be more used to it. But you're a bit used to it. Now you can watch the screen quickly, just to go through the nahu of it. Don't worry too much about the nahu of it, but just for interest sake. There are three words, you look at the words in the radio. There's darabaha and darabnaka. Let's just translate that quickly. Darabtuhu. Translate for me. Darab. Sorry, mistake. They're not darabatuhu. Just imagine sukun there. Darabtuhu. Darabtuhu means what? I hit him. Next one. Darabaha. Daraba and her. He hit her. Next one. Darabnaka. We hit you. Let's go to the first one again. Darabtuhu. Where is the doer of this word? What's a doer in Arabic called again? Fa'il. Fa'il is doer. Where is the doer of this word? You apply what? Eli. Eli. End. At the end of darabad, you see something there. You see darabtu. Can you see that two there is the doer? It represents I. Darabtu is the doer. Who is the I hitting? I'm hitting him. You with me? So we have the verb daraba, we have the doer, tu. And what do we have the who then? It's who the action is being done to. What do you call that person the action is being done to? Maf'ulun bihi. So can you see we have a whole verbal sentence here? We have verb, subject, object. We have verb, doer, to, and done upon. So there's an entire sentence in English. If I say English, you say, Dalatu, you say, I hit him. But yet it's all put into one word. You with me? Darabtuhu. Next one. Darabaha. Darabaha means he hit her. Where is the doer here? So we apply Eli. There's a ha at the end there. Is that the doer? Is she hitting? No. Is there anything on the left? Nothing. Nothing on the end, nothing on the left. Inside. What's inside there? What's inside? Who's eating? He. So there's a he inside. What's a he in Arabic? Huwa. There's a huwa inside there. There's a huwa inside there. That's why you say daraba, you say he hit. Not she hit or you hit, you say he hit. So there's a huwa inside daraba. So that huwa is the doer. What's the ha? It is the done upon. It is the maf'ulun bihi. The maf'ulun bihi, it is the done upon. So you have the verb daraba, the doers inside there, and that is the maf'ulun bihi, the done upon. Last one, darabnaka. Translation, we hit you. We hit you. Darabna, we hit, darabnaka. Where's the doer? That na. Eli, in, that na is the doer. Who's doing the action? Na, we. We is the action. Who is the action being done to? The ka, the you one male. You still with me? The ka is maf'ulun bihi. The ka is maf'ulun bihi. Must raise the camera. The ka is the maf'ulun bihi. Okay. So what I want to explain here, you must remember as a rule, inshallah, that whenever you have one of those who, whom, ha, hunaka, kum, ki, kunna, ina, attached to a verb, it will always be maf'ulun bihi. You with me? Whenever you have like a ka attached to a verb, listen to me, when you have a ka attached to a verb, it will always be maf'ulun bihi. It will always be maf'ulun bihi. So that's the nahu of it. That's all there is to it. Whenever you have any of those things attached to a verb, it will always be maf'ulun bihi. Okay. Because remember, we're still doing jumlatul fi'liya. So is this a jumla fi'liya? Tarabnaka. Is that a sentence? Tarabnaka. We hit you. That's a sentence. Okay. Now we're going to move on to some new work, inshallah. But before we get to the new work, I need you to get into your groups quickly. Get into your groups, find your groups, reconstitute your groups. Find your groups, inshallah. No one alone. Turn around if you're looking for someone. Find a friend. Not groups of two, inshallah. Three, four, five. Because two, there's still a chance you both will be lost. As we add more, the stats improve, inshallah. We are going to do some new work. We're going to do a nominal sentence, a noun-based sentence. To do a nominal sentence, I'm not going to teach you. Teach yourself, inshallah. So you're going to exercise book, you're going to page 29. Page 29 of your exercise book. It says there, it says, tables below and try to identify some rules that can be deduced. Write down the rules and complete the rest of the examples. So there's 18 examples, three of them have answers. You study those three. And then you write down the rest of the translation. Let me just go through some vocab that you might not know. I think number 8 you all not know. The word sahlun means easy. Sahlun means easy. In number 11, qawiyani, from the word qawiyun to mean strong. Number 13, the word qanitat. Qanitat, from the word qanit, means to be obedient. The rest of the words you should know, inshallah. If you don't know, you can ask someone. The rest of the words you should know, inshallah. So your work now. Your work now is to go through these examples. But the main thing is, yes, you must translate them, but identify the patterns. Identify the patterns of how the construction is made up. How the sentence is constructed, so you can spend a few minutes doing that, inshallah. Okay, Bismillah, let's go through it, inshallah. Let's go through it. Tell me, before you translate, notice about the patterns. Okay, good. In terms of, let's talk about the halat. What did you identify in terms of the halat? I remind you, there's three hals: raf'un, nasbun, jarrun. What did you identify about the three hals? Are all the first words in raf'un? Are all the second words in raf'un? Yes. So the first thing you notice here is that all the words at the beginning, the first word is always raf'un, even al-bintani and so on. Al-Muslimuna, Al-Mu'minatu, it's all raf'un. All the second words are also raf'un. Good. What else did you notice? The first word is what? The first word is always definite. Either it has an al or it's a proper noun. You with me? The first word is always definite. Al-waladu, al-bintu, al-shamsu, al-qamaru, Allah, proper noun. Muhammadun, proper noun. Ibrahimu, proper noun. Ad-darsu, al-Qur'anu. The first word is always what? Definite. What else do you notice? Okay, good. Okay, so I'll come to that now. If the first word is definite, what's the second word? It's always indefinite. I'll come to that now, inshallah. It's always indefinite. Can you see the first word's always definite? And the second word, everyone, tawilun, saghiratun, sirajun, nurun, azimun, there's no else. All of the second words are always indefinite. Did you see it or you didn't see it? You saw it. What else did you notice? Did you notice that the numbers always match? What do I mean by that? If you say al-waladu is single, tawil is single. But number 11, if I say al-rajulani, I don't say qawiyun, I say qawiyani. I make a deal. If I say number 12, muslimuna, I say una, salihuna. I'm always matching the numbers. What else do you notice? The gender also matches. Good, the gender also matches. What else do you notice? We'll come to nine, inshallah. Okay, good, good. In the English translation, there's an extra word you don't see in the Arabic translation. What is that? Is or are. You see, when I say al-waladu tawilun, I don't say the tall boy or a tall boy. I say the boy is tall. Can you see I implied, I read into it and is. So let's go to the first one. Al-waladu tawilun, the boy is tall. Is that a sentence? Does it convey a complete meaning? The boy is tall. Can you see it's a sentence? If I said the tall boy, is that a sentence? If I say assalamu alaikum, the tall boy. No. If I say assalamu alaikum, the boy is tall, you'll say mashallah. He's very tall, yes. So al-waladu tawilun means the boy is tall. The boy is tall. So what did I add? I added an is. Now if you look at the word al-walad and al-tawil, do you see is al-walad a ism or a fi'l or a harf? It's an ism. What is the boy? How about tawil? Is tawil tall? Is it the ism, fi'l, or harf? Is it a ism, a fi'l, or a harf? Okay, is it a verb? Did you tawil lately? No. You can't tawil. Tawil is in English a description, an adjective. So it's definitely not a verb. So the harf, remember within ism is what? What's ism again? Noun. Person, place, thing, idea, adjective, adverb, and more. Remember? An adjective is part of ism. So it's an ism. Ism. Can you see? Al-walad is ism and tawil is ism. So what do we have together? We have two isms. Guess what this is called? Al-jumlatul ismiyah. What you're doing now is called what? Al-jumlatu al-ismiyah. Why? Because it's a sentence without a verb. It's a sentence without a verb. You don't get this in English, really. I don't think you get it in English. I think all English sentences have a verb, which is at least an is. Now, in Arabic, you get a sentence without a verb. There's a sentence without a verb. It's jumlatul ismiya. Jumlatul ismiya. Al-waladu tawilun, the boy is tall. Al-bintu saghiratun, the girl is tall. Ash-shamsu sirajun, the sun is a. Al-qamaru nurun, what's qamar? The moon is what? Is a light. The moon is light or is a light. Allahu azimun, Allah is great, Allah is mighty. Muhammadun rasulun, Muhammad is a messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Someone asked me, why does Muhammad have a tanween? Is because that's where I write Muhammad with a tanween. Because that's how it's an Arabic word. Muhammad is a normal Arabic word, so it's written with a tanween. Other names like Ibrahim is considered to be from originally from non-Arabic origin, so they don't have a tanween. So if it's like an Arabic word, like salih, you'll say salihun. But other kind of imported words or assimilated words, it doesn't take a tanween. Next one, Ibrahimu Nabiyun. Translation? Ibrahim is a prophet. Next one, Ad-Darsu Sahlun. The lesson is, if you say Islam is the truth, you say Al-Islamu Huwa Haqqun. But we're not there yet, that's later on inshallah. Next year. Al-Islamu haqqun, Islam is truth. Next one. Ar-rajulani qawiyyani. You say here, the two males are strong. You don't say the two males are too strong. You just say the two males are strong. The two males are strong. Next one. Al-Muslimuna salihuna. The Muslims are pious. The Muslims are righteous. Next one. Al-Mu'minatu qanitatun. The females are obedient. We don't mean to their husbands here, we mean to Allah. I'm just saying, it's we all qanit, inshallah, to Allah. Qanit actually means to be willfully, willingly obedient. Like qanit is not something you do because you have to do it. Qanit is something when you love to obey Allah, that's called qanit. We like you desire to submit to Allah, that's called qanit. Next one, as-salatu fardun. Salah, you can just say the salah because it's a proper noun. Or the salah, salah is compulsory. Next one, at-tulabu muslimuna. Let's pause quickly. The word tulab is not, what's the word of tulab? Talib is one student. Many students are tulab. So at-tulab means is a plural. I can see I'm matching it there with Muslimuna, also plural, but the one's broken in the one sound. At-tulabu, the students are Muslim. The students are Muslim. Next one. Bintani talibatani. Translation? The two girls are students. Next one. Al-Muslimu salihun. The Muslim is pious. Last one, al-Muslimat. There's a mistake there. Can't be al-Muslimatun. Why not? You can't have al-Watanwin ever in Arabic. So it's a mistake there. Not al-Muslimatun. Al-Muslimatu. The Muslima, the female Muslim, salihatun. The Muslim is pious. It's al-Muslimatu salihatun. Because second word is always indefinite. Second word is always indefinite. Okay. Let's watch the screen for a moment. We are doing jumla. Under jumla, in the whole Arabic language, you only have how many types of jumla? Two jumlas. What are they? Al-jumlatul fi'liyya and al-jumlatul ismiyya. What is al-jumlatul fi'liyya? A verbal sentence or a verb-based sentence. How do I know when I have jumlatul fi'liyya? Whenever you see a verb, you have a verbal sentence. No, really, if you see a verb, it's a verbal sentence. That's the meaning of it. If you see a verb, it's a verbal sentence. Now we're going to do al-jumlatul ismiyya. You've done now 18 and jumlatul ismiyas. Right? You have 18 of them in your mind. Okay, so I'm going to go through the theory quickly of it. Translate for me quickly. Ar-rajulu tawilun. The man is tall. Okay. Now, jumlatul ismiyah, I don't know, people take long to get it. Like maybe a couple of years sometimes. But the structure of a jumlatul ismiyah, and maybe you want to awake now, but just be awake quickly now. Just deep breath, take a deep breath, just get some, inshallah. You with me? Okay. The structure of a jumlatul ismiyah is always going to be something is something. That's the structure. I have something, and I'm giving you more news about it. So what do I have here as the focus? Ar-rajul, the man. What is the news about the man? That he is tall. I'm not describing, I'm not saying the tall man, I'm saying the man, what about him? He is tall. So jumlatul ismiyah always has two parts. the thing I'm speaking about, the focus of the sentence, and the news information I'm conveying about that thing. You with me? That's the two parts. So something is something. That's how your brain works, but that's another discussion, inshallah. Your brain continuously says something is something. That's all your brain does all the time. Like you go shopping and look at the shelf, you say, that thing is something I need. Look at something else, that is a good brand. Look at something else, that is expensive. Something else, that is on special. I have to buy it. No. So you always say something is something. That's how your brain works. It passes judgments all the time. Now the Jumlatul Ismiyah has two parts. Two parts. The first part is called Mubtada. Or Mubtada'un or Mubtada. You say it together? Mubtada. What do you think the root letters of Mubtada are? What do you think the root letters of Mubtada are? You must switch between this. No? All the time. No. What do you think the root is of Mubtada are? Ba, Dal, Alif. Or Ba, Dal, Hamza. Bada'a. What does Bada'a mean? Means to begin. So Bada is the begin. So Mubtada is the thing that I'm beginning with. It's the focus of the sentence. What am I explaining now? If in case you're lost, I'm explaining to you how Jumlatul Ismiyah works. Okay, so just be with me here. Because if you lose it now, then you're going to wait till third year, fourth year, until you find it again. So the first part is called what? Mubtada. It is the beginning of the sentence. It's the focus of the sentence. Okay. The second part is called Khabarun or Khabar. Khabarun or Khabar. Say it together. Khabar. What's the first part called? First part? Mubtada. Second part? Mubtada khabar. One more time. Mubtada khabar. What does khabar mean? News. Good. In fact, if you go to an Arab country and you put on the news, you know what it's called? Al-akhbar. Al-akhbar is the plural of khabar. It means news. So khabar means news. So the second part of the sentence is called khabar, is called news. Why is it called khabar? Because it gives you news about the beginning of the sentence. Are you with me? It gives you news about the beginning of the sentence. It gives you information about the beginning of the sentence. Okay. So those are the two parts of what? Jumlatul Ismiyah. Let me pause and go back to Jumlatul Fi'liyah. When I think about the parts of a Jumlatul Fi'liyah, what parts do I think about? Let's start from the beginning. Jumlatul fi'liya. What do I think about? Okay, before fa'il, think about the fi'l first. Jumlatul fi'liya, a part of Jumlatul fi'liya is a fi'l, is a verb. That's called Jumlatul fi'liya. What other part do I think about? Fa'il, who's doing the verb? So I think about fa'il as a part. You with me? What else do I think about? Maf'ul bihi, who has it been done to? So I think about three things in Jumlatul Fi'liyah. What is the verb? Who is doing the verb? And who is the verb being done to? That's Jumlatul Fi'liyah's lesson. Okay, just absorb. Put it there in your mind. Now I come to Jumlatul Ismiyah. I think about different stuff. You with me? Different stuff. I think about Mubtada and Khabar. Mubtada and Khabar. I think about what is the focus, the beginning of the sentence, and what is the news about that thing. You with me? It's a different type of construction. It's a different type of construction. It's a noun-based construction. Noun I'm talking about, and give me news about that noun. Muhammadun Rasulun. Who am I speaking about? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What am I saying about him? Rasulun, the news is a messenger. Ad-darsu sahlun. What's the thing I'm starting with? The lesson, what am I saying about the lesson? The news is, it is easy. Al-Islamu haqqun, what am I starting with? Al-Islam, the deen Islam, what about it? Haqqun, it is truth. Al-Waladu tawilun, I'm starting with Al-Walad, that's the mubtada thing I'm beginning with, and I'm saying it's tawil, it is, he is tall. So you understand the construction, you're looking for those two parts. When you have mubtada and khabar, you have jumlatul ismiyah. Okay. So you understand, hopefully you understand a bit how it works. Now some of the signs to identify it. Some of the signs. This is like a long lesson. I don't finish it until next year. It doesn't mean I'm going to teach you the whole year this one thing. It means I'm going to give you a bit now, but then next year you're going to learn there's five types of khabar. And I only gave you one in first year. They're like, why didn't you give us all four? Let's just give you one for now. Then in second year, we do the other khabars. Because sometimes the khabar can also be jumatul fi'liyah, but then if I said now, then you all drop out, so just now is easy. So I'm saying there's five khabars, I'm giving you one for now, but the one is sufficient for you for now. Then later on, maybe I'll give you two, maybe in a month's time, and then maybe like three more next year. Just easy. Easy, inshallah. But it's based on the experience, inshallah, and how to sequence the lessons. What was I saying? Some of the signs. For now, generally speaking, there's always going to be exceptions and changes later on and so on. For now, if you can just tell the class to join this class, inshallah, I don't have a clock here. In about 45 seconds, inshallah. Okay, so what's happening here? Some of the signs are going to be, how do you see Jumlatul Ismiyah? Just like you see it there. Both words will be in Raf'un. Both words will be in Raf'un. The first one will be definite. The one will be indefinite. That's for now is enough. All of that's going to change again later on. But for now, that's enough. It's two words. They're both in Raf'un. The first one's definite. And the second one is indefinite. When I see it, what do? Most important thing is I insert an is or are in between them. That's the most important thing. Because the next lesson we're going to do, inshallah, is the tall boy. No is or are. But in this lesson, I say the boy is tall. The boy is tall. Yeah? Same rules. The mubtada is always in raf'un. The khabar is always in raf'un. With me? Another rule here. The mubtada is generally definite. Not 100%, but generally for now is going to be definite. The khabar is generally indefinite. Okay. Your homework, inshallah. I remind you about homework as work you do at home. I don't know how many more times to say that, inshallah, but homework is work you do at home. Sometimes even second year, third year, fourth year, they still don't get that concept. You know, some fundamental concepts take a while to become established, inshallah. Okay, so your homework, work you do at home, is on page 30. Okay. One last thing. With me, one last thing. Look at the number two. Hiya talibatun. Hiya talibatun. Translate it for me. Hiya talibatun. Translate it for me. She. Hiya is she, and talibatun is student. So she is student. What am I saying? She is a student. Can you see that's the same sound? Like if I'd say Maryamu talibatun, I'd say Maryam is a student. But instead of saying Maryam, I'm saying she. Hiya talibatun. So just a note, inshallah, whenever you have these detached pronouns, it's also going to be a mubtada khabar construction. Your silence. Say again. Okay. When you have these detached pronouns, huwa, whom, hiya, hunna, anta, antum, anti, antunna, ana, nahnu, when you have that, it's going to be a jumlatul ismiya consisting mubtada and khabar. The only difference here is that the first word, you can't see the raf'un. Like, for example, if I say huwa, I don't say huwu, huwa, huwi. Huwa is always huwa. It's like a fixed word. It's always like that. So it's going to be a mubtada khabar construction. If you, next week I'll spend some more time to explain it. Why I'm mentioning it now is because on page 29, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 examples, 7 examples have a pronoun at the beginning. But anyway, just bismillah. All you must do is on page 29, page 30, sorry, page 30, what you must do is just translate and above the mubtada put a meme and above the khabar put a kha. So translated, above the mubtada put a meem, above the khabar put a kha. If you can't find the vocab, in the first column is the Quranic reference. These all comes from the Quran as well. So you can look up there for the words in the Quran if you can't find the vocab, or you can look in a dictionary, inshallah. Can we just check, is that class here? Tawra? The second year? Just check if they're here, inshallah? No. Okay, sorted. That's today's lesson. Tomorrow, next week we'll revise some more, but that's Jumlatul Ism.